hope you get to hear me now. If you get to hear me now.
Hello everyone, welcome to this new channel and to this new game called 4X-Galaxy. Basically, it's a Chinese 4X type of game. You know, 4X means exploit, explore, exchange, and exterminate. Yes, sir, and yes, ma'am. Anyway, the game been around, I don't know, for how much for the Chinese version. It's been here for a while, I guess. But the English version is quite new. It's really new because it starts in 20th December 2018, and it's really interesting game. It's like a simplest version of EVE Online. You can do whatever you want. You wanna be a trader, I mean someone who just take goods from place to place and sell them, you can do that. You wanna be an explorer and go explore the vast galaxies and the whole universe, yes sir, you can do that. You wanna be a pirate, a scumbag that's gonna steal from everyone, yes sir, you can do that too, or ma'am, I don't know. And if you wanna be I don't know, some sort of justice man or woman, you can do that too. Just be a bounty hunter and go hunt those pirates. I was going to say the bad word, so nah, we will not say that. Okay, okay, let's get started. So let's log in. By the way, this is my second account. I just wanna show you guys around. So yeah, we'll try to do it quickly. So here is the ISA, Interstellar Citizen Information Initialization. They want me to join then. I want to join. Okay, here's the, what it called, professions or titles. You can later on the game get whatever you want. I'm just gonna start with bounty hunter. Yeah, let's go. I will start with bounty hunter and let's see. Okay, I'm a male, of course. And let's take our pick. I need a face that will not be used a lot and send some. Let's go with humans. This smuggle face, I don't love it. But I do have beard, not that much. But yeah. I have glasses like this one. But definitely not like this one. But yeah, let's see. Ah, damn, I can't choose. Okay, let's just choose this one. Go with it, who cares? Yeah, let's go. Okay, the photo is there. Okay, enter your name. I cannot use Ashragon because I already have an account. With that name, I mean. Okay, you know what? I will not type Death Star Hoey. Okay, let's go, Death Star Hoey. Anyway, yes, please. Entering the Interstellar. So, yes. Okay, come on, game. This is strange. It does load fast because it has no big graphics, you know, it's simple graphics, but it's awesome. And Just so you know, guys, you can even play this game on a low-spec PC with no problem. Laptop or desktop, it doesn't matter. It's really no problem because it has a kind of graphic that works on mobile phones and tablets. Even the UI is really similar to tablets or phones. But yeah, it's really good game in my humble opinion, and I do love this game and I want people to give it a try. Just do the tutorials as I will show you guys and you will be set and done for doing your stuff, and just don't get bored in the tutorials, because I did see some people that just get bored in the tutorials and give the game early opinion. They just from scratch said, okay, this game is bad or this game is good. So just people just try it out and you will see. So here it is, a tutorial about the basics, you know, WASD as any game. Here's what gets tricky. Okay, as you notice in this, you see that this is a lot similar to the phones and tablet UI. That's what I mean. Like, the game UI is really similar to that. Got it, we don't care. So, they want me to use G, I will not, I will click on G. So like that, I can aim. You see, I can aim here and adjust it and like that again and boom. See, I can keep clicking while I'm adjusting. I mean, I click, I hold, so I adjust my shoot and I just do that. I cannot scroll down. Okay, I will use my skills. Those are skills. Can scroll down and you will just zoom in or zoom out. I wanted to zoom out so I can see from above and see everything clear, because it's a strategic view point of view, it's a strategic point of view, and in that situation, in this type of battles, you need to see where is your enemy. So yeah. And also, it is an instance battle type of game. I mean, it is not turn-based, but you know, when you do a battle, you just jump in to an instance. So you play in an instance. People can pass by you and see you fighting with animation, but they cannot interfere unless they are in your team. I said team, not group, because groups here is a sort of clan. So let's get into it. I will just do some quests, I will not do everything, so the video will not be long and heavy, and I just want you guys to get into it, and I will do the bounty hunter, and maybe I will go to explore tutorials, but we will see that later on other videos. So now I will just start with my the tutorial that the game gives and see how things goes.
Mission failed.
Okay, mission failed because the bastard just killed me. Okay. It is strange. Okay, so here we are. This is a battleship. It's really good ship. It has long range. Well, we will get to these details later in another video. I will just put a video that explains every ship by its own. Okay, they give me, let's just collect them all. It is, gifts, I guess. So, yeah.
Location,
let's hit return.
Online.
Basically, this is a question. When you want to go to the quest
I'm
objective,
here,
just click on this shortcut and you will go directly to it. So, yada yada. I don't need to read it because if I read it, it will be a long video and I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this. Yes. Okay. Go to Earth. Now they want us to change, I think, the ship. When you click here, you see the window, the quest window. Yeah. If you click here, this is a minimap. It's hard to notice that there is a minimap here because it's transparent. But you kind of see these dots. There are stations. For example, this is a station. This is you. And yeah.
Location system.
Sorry. Oh. Okay, so I'm in a station. So they will show me around and stuff like this. So they said click on ports so you can see the ships and you can equip the ships. So yeah. And let's change it. They said change to cargo ship. So yeah, let's go around with the cargo ship. And for example, here they will ask us to buy some materials and go to other planets that will demand this with a higher price. Basically, this is trading. This is trading. Basically, you go to a galaxy and planets, specific planets or station. This is a station, not a planet. It's a station on the planet. So you choose you see what other planets ask. For example, here in this case we have a planet that asks for, or a station that asks for oxygen with a higher price. Of course you will adjust it, buy this by 20 ATH, and ATH is this blue triangle thing here. This is what it is. We will get to this later on, this also later on, and I will explain everything in details. Right now let's continue. And yeah, okay, got it. So they ask us to click on the minimap and go to Saturn. We'll click on Saturn and click go. Yes, I wanna set sail to this planet.
Location system.
Here you see your speed. It is in astronomical units. I guess it's called astronomical units. I lose this word a lot. By the way, the spaces between, or the distances between planet to planets, are real. Like for example, I did know that the distance between Neptune and Earth, it is 30.1 astronomical units. I think it is 150 million kilometers or something. Anyway, and I did travel with my ship from Neptune to Earth while calculating this by time and see how much time I did go there, and it was really the same as real life. It was 30.1 astronomical units. And also planets are really detailed. Well, from this point of view, of course we will not get inside a planet. By the way, you see I clicked on a icon just appeared here. It is a booster, a thruster or something. It boosts your engine so you go faster. For example, you see that I went from 8 astronomical units to 14 or 16. I didn't kind of doublets, you see, and each ship has its own speed and stuff. The fastest are explorers and assault ships, I think predator ships too, but I'm not sure. So here in this exchange is always where you will find what it called, resources, and you can even sell or buy like this. If you don't find a kind of, for example, let's do this, and I don't find it, I click here. Where here? Why didn't? No, I don't want it. I just want to click. I think they want, they don't. Okay, here it is. Sorry, that was okay. I know now. Don't click on the icon as I did. It was dumb, because when you click into the icon, click here, you know where it is, where the station that reproduce this kind of resource. You can just go over there. But if you want to buy it and you don't find it anywhere, and you know people will have it, you just adjust the price you want to pay for it, and the amount of thing you want, and how much time you want it to be here. Because for example, if we say one day and one day pass, this this order will be cancelled, and you will check your orders here. So anyway, let's get into our tutorial, and I want to sell this all. Okay, it just called, or I just called 80H gold, or the money of the game. I just call it gold. This is strange. I mean, my character called this gold, not me. But yeah. I see. Okay. Now they ask us to do bounty hunter. I will just accept this one. No. Oh, okay. Okay, they give us a cruiser, but wait. You need always to do your quests. I just give up this one. You need always to do your quests, and every 3 hours this quest, if you finish all these quests, every 3 hours they will refresh. And even if you don't them, they will refresh anyway. So always do your quests, everything. Except if you are, for example, if you are a bounty hunter, you have a bounty hunter ship, don't do pirate ships, underground missions or quests, because it's kind of hard on your type of ship. But if you have plunder or predator ships and assault ships, yeah, of course you can do them, because you can do them. So yeah, we will go into this in details in another video. They want us to do this. Sorry. Just a habit. I sail very fast. This is just a damn habit and a bad one. In my mind, I just saw a cargo ship and I said, okay, I need to sell something. So I have already the cargo. So yeah, this is what's gone into my mind. Sorry. So yeah, I need to change it to cruiser, because in cargo ships are the victims. I'm not saying it in a bad way, but yeah, they are the victims. They need cruisers to protect them from assault ships and predator ships. They will give us predator ships later on. So yeah, now we can just click onto this and we will sail immediately, or click on sail, go to port and then click on sail as I did, and you will
location
go
system
automatically. So yeah, and as you see, it is a little bit faster than the cargo ship, and the higher tire you go, the more speed and advanced attack you have in your ships. For example, it's ships, and you will see this is what we have. We can build it to this, then to this or this, and then to this or this, etc., etc. I just put these two in my collection. It's called collection because you can use it. So why I do that? Because I want to build them, and I think we don't have these yet. So yeah, we don't have these yet. So yeah, let's continue.
Who are you? What do you want?
Okay, I love his voice.
Attention all personnel.
So yeah, basically I love playing it like that because I kind of see where my enemies are, and I can do this. He was about to hit me. Oh. Okay, he's done. And I can dodge it. Okay. So yeah. You can change this,
mission
you can hide
complete.
The grid, and you can keep it. I recommend keeping it because you can see how far the enemy is, and you can predict when he can touch you and when he can't, because each ship has its own range, and if you have a cruiser or battleship, you better put this on. I clicked on guide here, so I collect my rewards. These are just one time reward, and each time you do them they will give you a reward. Not each time, because you cannot do them
location
each time. So
system
asking us to go to Jupiter. I can do this and then click on, oh my god, Jupiter is away, and go to Jupiter, or just click
location
here and I will
online.
Go automatically to Jupiter. It is 3 minutes, 4 minutes actually, not 3 minutes, and yeah, traveling in this game is a bit of lots and a bit of a problem. But it's really necessary because you want to travel to a planet, from a planet to another planet. So please, come on, you will not do it in 1 second, of course. Even though this speed is crazy, it's really crazy. I'm going with 9 astronomical units per minute. Come on, it's really, it's really high. So yeah, and yeah. Maybe I will skip the, no, maybe I will skip the traveling and editing this video, I don't know, but let's see, if the video is long enough, I will edit this and just speed it up, otherwise I will keep it. I never felt like this before. It seems really way, way too far. Oh my god. Oh. Let's go.
Boosting.
Something and I forget it. Yeah, while we are flying, why not? So I'm a military, I'm a bounty hunter, I'm a hunter, and if I want, like, for example, trader or businessman, I just need to go this and level it up, tack. I think I need just one, and when you level it up one, you will get, yeah, it needs level one and you get businessman. Diplomacy is not yet implemented in the game. I have no idea about this one, but yeah. Explore again, you need just to level up these two and you're good to go with it. Pirates again. But yeah, so this, and each one has its benefits. that, we will see that in another video. Right now, I just wanted to tell you that it is possible to change profession or titles as you want and as you wish. You can just change whatever you want. For example, this minute you are a hunter, and another you can just go businessman, and it doesn't take time to change or anything. Basically, it's like hunter. Here it's activated, but it will be green and it will be saying activation or activate, something like that, and you click on it and it's done. So yeah, here we go, we are in Jupiter finally. So crystal is a necessary material for scientific research in the universe. Okay, so they will give me, I think, crystals for free. By the way, each station will give you a free, kind of free trading. So every new station built will give you for one time a possibility to sell resources with a high price, like double or even triple the price. So just do this, and basically the money, the in-game money, is not that hard to gather. It's really easy. But yeah, if you have problem with that, just do your missions and do trading. And okay, I found something in the bar. I think each station has a bar. We will go to that in details later on. Now let's do exploration. So there is two type of mini game in exploration. I just need to find something. There is an asteroid. Okay, good.
Location,
let's
system.
Go to the abandoned cargo first. I wish I have something here near 9 astronomic. 9, is it still 9? Okay, we'll go to this
location
one.
System offline.
So I'm taking the survey, and here it is. Basically, what you need to do, if you click on that exclamation point, you need to fill all the emptiness here, and then you got it. For example, A will go here, B will go here. Not there, but okay, wait. If C goes this way, B will go this way, A will go this way, and D will go this way. Here we go. So yeah, this is what it is. We have another one. I just wanna show it to you guys. They gave me Dracula. A predator ship, where it is not abnormal, because abnormal is the same as abandoned cargo. There is 9 astronomical units. Abandoned signal. I just saw it. Wait, okay.
Location system.
I wanna go for this asteroid so you can see. For the ships, I will not do the plunder ship or the predator ship. I will not do pirates anyway, because I really don't want the video to be so long. And I will do later on a video on each type of ships, each one of them, and the gameplay and the style of them. And everything, and yeah, let's show you guys the other type of survey, and let's finish
location
the video.
System
so, yeah.
Offline.
Each time you use crystals for the survey, I will explain this. Okay, so here, if I click like this randomly, I may find these waters or not. It's water, and I will have 19. And if you click here, they will show you the scheme or the way you need to find them. And for example, it can be anyway. Okay, I found one, so it will be 1, 2. It can be anyway, it's luck. That's why I love the other kind of survey. That's why here again we have something to collect. I have this to collect, nothing else. Okay, what else I want? Okay, survey, you can upgrade them by upgrading or leveling up your skills here. Upgrading these two to higher is 10, level max is 10, so yeah, you can, it's 10 plus 10 survey. Here it's plus 10 survey again, and this is for advanced abandoned cargo. Sorry, I read it wrong. This is for abandoned cargo and anomalies. It's abnormal signals, the blue one, and this one is for asteroids and debris or wreckage. Outside this skills, it's called wreckage. I don't know why the difference here, but anyway, it doesn't matter. These are skills you need to level up and upgrade. You need to use some materials to do that, and we will see that later. For now, I just want to say that I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you will join the game, join me in the game. It's really awesome game, it's really good game. It's on Steam. Just type 4X Galaxy and you will find it on Steam. Please do subscribe and like if you like the video, and share it with other friends, and join us into the 4X Galaxy. Till then, I say peace out.